Columns of steam at Wairākei, just north of Taupō, sometimes waft across the highway, letting travellers know that they are in one of the most active geothermal areas in the world. A lot of New Zealand's electricity is produced through renewable sources, such as hydropower. However, after severe droughts in the late 1940s, the government set about harnessing the geothermal potential at Wairākei. Geothermal power was seen as a good alternative, because unlike hydro, solar and wind power, it is not affected by the weather. Construction began in 1958, and when it was completed in 1963, Wairākei was only one of two geothermal stations in the world. There are now 8 geothermal power stations in New Zealand alone. Despite providing a reliable and cost-effective electricity supply, geothermal power stations can have a detrimental effect on the environment. When the Wairākei scheme started extracting heat from the ground, there was an immediate decline in geothermal activity in the area. The ground sagged in some places, and hot springs and geysers began to die as the supply of steaming water from below was depleted. In Geyser Valley, the famous Wairākei geyser, which had been attracting tourists since the 1880s, with its water spouting up to 42 metres high, stopped completely. Then the famous Champagne Pool, a boiling spring with a blue tint, dwindled away. Geyser Valley continued to deteriorate, and in 1973 it was shut down as a tourist attraction. Extracting geothermal fluids can also reduce the pressure in underground reservoirs and cause the land to sink. At Wairākei, the centre of the subsidence is sinking at a rate of almost half a metre every year. In 2005, this ground was 14 metres lower than it was before the power station was built. Geothermal fluids contain some toxic elements. If waste is released into rivers or lakes instead of being injected back into the geothermal field, these pollutants can damage aquatic life and make the water unsafe for drinking or irrigation. However, the craters of the moon near Wairākei have actually seen a boost in geothermal activity, because the underground pools have got hotter and now produce more steam. This is now one of only a few thermal areas still active in the Wairākei geothermal field. Most of New Zealand's geothermal energy goes to produce electricity, but it can be used for any processes where heat is required. The world's only geothermally heated prawn farm was established in 1987 on the banks of the Waikato River, next to the Wairākei power station. The first giant river prawns, which require warm temperatures of around 26 degrees centigrade, were imported from Malaysia in 1988. By 2005, the farm was producing about 20 tonnes per year. The prawn farm heats its water with heat from Wairākei power station's wastewater before it flows back into the Waikato River. The prawns live for 9 months, before being harvested and sold exclusively to local restaurants. This is a good example of what is known as cascade use, where geothermal heat has a function past its primary purpose. Cascading improves the overall efficiency of a resource by using its waste products. In the case of the prawn farm, cascading also reduces the discharge of hot water into the river, where it can harm aquatic life. Geothermal waters are also used for heating greenhouses for the production of vegetables, flowers and fruit. A tropical orchid, Phalaeopsis, is grown in large geothermally heated greenhouses, using waste heat from the nearby Wairākei power station. The warm atmosphere inside the greenhouse mimics the monsoon conditions of the orchid's natural habitat.